Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm filming an exciting video. It is my small eyeshadow palette collection video. So this particular video is going to feature eyeshadow palettes that are less than 9 shades, and then I'm going to have them be smaller than the ColourPop 9 pan palettes, so anything smaller than the monochromatic palettes. I'm using the same rules as my friend Angelica. She recently filmed a mini eyeshadow palette video and I was totally inspired by that video. So I will go ahead and remember to link that down in the description box so you guys can check out her video as well. And without further blabbering, let's get into it. Okay guys, just want to define what I will be classifying as a mini palette. So this is a ColourPop 9 pan palette. And as you can see, this palette has 9 eyeshadows, but it is smaller than a ColourPop 9 pan palette. So I will be including this palette in my minis. And then this is bigger than the ColourPop palette, but it is under 9 eyeshadows. So I will be counting this as a mini eyeshadow palette because there's only 6 shades in that. So hopefully that is clear. And now let's get on to my collection. So the first palette I want to show you guys is this one. This is G-Train by Urban Decay. I picked this up quite recently and I have filmed an eyeshadow look with this, so it is coming up on my channel. It's cute. I would not recommend purchasing this full price. I got it on sale for like 12 bucks, which is the reason I picked it up. But if I had to pay full price for it, I definitely would be passing on this palette. Okay, the next mini palettes I want to show you guys are these little cuties from Midas Cosmetics. If you didn't know, now you do. I am an affiliate with Midas, so if you use my code KHMAKEUP, you save money on Midas. So I've used this palette. I actually bought that one myself, and then Midas sent me some in PR as well. So here is what they all look like. They're so cute, and they have these cute little sleeves. So there they are, and I plan on filming a look with these cute little palettes. I just haven't gotten to it yet, so you'll see those in my channel soon. Okay, next little mini is this guy, and again, you will see a video on this hopefully soon. This is a little mini palette I picked up when Makeup Geek did their rebranding. I was so interested in this green shade that I scooped it right up, and yeah, it's super cute. It comes in this little magnetic palette, and it's a cute little quad, so I definitely see myself doing an eye look with this soon. Next is my only Melt stack that I currently have in my collection. This is the Blueprint stack. I wasn't planning on buying this stack, but I caught it on sale and I was kind of curious to try it out and see if Melt stack formula had evolved at all. I don't really love their stacks, so I was very curious to find out. And honestly, I haven't used this in a long, long time, so I don't even really have a formulated review on this yet, but I will work on it. It's on my list. So I recently posted a video on these guys. These are from Makeup Revolution and they are their Revolution Pro Ultimate Eye Look palettes. These are so cute and everyone's freaking out about the packaging. I think they are decently pigmented. Are these my favorite small eyeshadow palettes? No, but everyone was kind of nuts for the packaging because it's so fun and different and quite luxurious looking for Revolution Pro. It's not really always known for having expensive looking products, so everyone was really curious about this. I'll try and remember to link any videos I have on the palettes I'm mentioning in the description box for you guys to check out if you're interested. Okay, here's another little guy that I have a video on. This is the Makeup Revolution or iHeart Revolution Mini Tasty Avocado palette, and here's what it looks like. Super duper cute. This was like 10 bucks and I am such a sucker for green eyeshadow palettes. I think you'll see quite a few of them in this video. Okay, so here's another one by iHeart Revolution. This is the Heartbreaker palette. I haven't used this on my eyes yet, but this was like under $10 as well. I think this was like a $7 palette and I just threw it into an Ulta order because I mean, how cute is that and why not? Okay, here's another random little mini palette. This is from the original Moschino Sephora collab. They came out with this little shopping bag palette. I've used it once or twice and I haven't used it since, but isn't it so cute? I love keeping this on display in my makeup collection. Okay, so I didn't think I had a lot of mini palettes from Dose of Colors, but turns out I do. So this is the Mini and the Mickey palette. As you can see, I kept the box for the Mickey palette, but I've only used these two palettes a few times. I need to definitely use them more. They're not really my favorite palettes in the whole world, so I'm kind of like wondering why I purchased them. I think I was like in the mood to collect them, but they're so neutral, like I hardly ever even think to reach for these. So yeah, I guess I'm collecting these, but they're so cute. I don't know, it's kind of like sophisticated Disney World and Disneyland. But let me know if you guys have these palettes, because I think they're probably some of the oldest palettes you'll see in this video. Okay, so another mini palette. This is the Kaja stack I have, or it's called a bento box. This is the Orange Blossom. I picked this up very, very recently when I was in New York with some of my YouTube friends, and I just kind of wanted a little memorabilia item. So there are the shades. These are so cute. I really wish Kaja would make more fun colors. I'd love to see these in like a green, a blue, and maybe a yellow. I think that would be so fun. So if Kaja ever sees this, I'm requesting more shades. I didn't start out loving these palettes from Pat McGrath, but I did love this collection. I think this was their holiday 2018 collection that they came out with, and it's so stunning. If you guys are familiar with the brand, you've seen these before. I love the red one. The blue one is my next favorite one. It's so cute. There's this beautiful like purple shade, and then we have the pink one, which was like an all shimmer palette from her. Super cute. And then she very recently did this Star Wars themed palette collection, so of course I had to grab those. So my husband is a huge Star Wars fan, and then I don't know why I felt like I wanted this, but this is the Lunar New Year palette, and it's really nice for every day. So if you guys have the chance to pick this up because you want to try Pat McGrath's formula, this is a really good palette, and it is still available from what I know. Okay, so I have two more mini palettes from Pat McGrath to talk about. These were her holiday palettes from 2019, and so I bought two of them. I didn't buy the super neutral one. I bought this one, and then I bought the pink one because I thought it was going to be a Pat McGrath exclusive. That turned out to be kind of baloney, because then they came available on Sephora, so I definitely regret purchasing the pink one because I don't necessarily love it. And I feel like this one is beautiful, but it feels a little overpriced for what it is. I mean, it's fun because you get to try her special shades, but if you've seen her 10 pan palettes, I think that those ones are still better than this little guy. So I would say just go for the big palettes if you ever have the chance to pick up Pat McGrath. Okay, these purchases were definitely inspired by my friend Angelica. These are like her favorite little mini palettes from Nabla. This guy is so cute. This is such a nice formula. It's like a cream to powder. And sometimes I'm just like a sucker for a good neutral palette with like beautiful shimmer shades, and that's exactly what this one is. You can pick these up on Ulta because Ulta sells Nabla, and so does Morphe. And then this is Angie's favorite one. I don't know why mine's a little smush, but Ulta tried to send me these like multiple times over, and just having the worst luck with this one shade because it keeps shattering. But this is the other color, and I personally like the really neutral one, but I bought both because you guys know I stan Angie. So anything she loves, I love to try because I'm always curious and I really enjoy her taste in makeup. There's a little swatch of that pink shade that was shattered. Okay, here's another cute collection of minis that launched this year. These are by Juvia's Place, and they did four mini palettes, super duper cute. I love all of these. The chocolate one, again, is such a beautiful neutral. The nudes is so neutral, but it's beautiful. I think you can definitely use these in conjunction with each other. And then I really like the violets as well. It's a beautiful purple palette. I did do like a little battle of the purple mini palettes because you guys all wanted to see this against Violet Ink versus It's my pleasure and I like you a lot. So I'll try and remember to link that video in the description box as well. And these are so cute and just, I don't know, they just look like little books. Aren't they adorable? Okay, next mini palettes I have are from ColourPop. I don't think any of these are available for purchase anymore, but I do have them, so I just wanted to show you them. This is the Pretty Much palette. We have the Make Up Your Mind palette. This one was put together by customers of ColourPop. They got to pick out the shades. And then this was the first one they ever did. This is called the Take Me Home palette. I really like this because it's a really small neutral palette and you can do like some really great like everyday looks with this. So I like to keep this around in case I ever like need it for something, and the money's already spent. So I don't know, they're just really cute little guys. Okay, so next I have my one Charlotte Tilbury quad. This is Pillow Talk. I definitely drank the Pillow Talk Kool-Aid when it first launched, and she was making it seem so limited edition. It was so exclusive and nobody was gonna get their hands on it, blah 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 blah. This quad unfortunately is a little too light for me. It's really gently pigmented, but I keep it around because it looks gorgeous on lighter skin tones. So if my friends ever ask me to do their makeup on like a special occasion or anything like that, I love to reach into this and use this on lighter skin tones because it's stunning. So if you have a lighter skin tone, I would totally recommend checking out Charlotte Tilbury's Pillow Talk Quad. Okay guys, so these mini palettes have basically been breaking the internet for e.l.f. These came out this year and they're so cute. They're $3 and I do have a review with these, and I've also been doing little like battles with these palettes because they are such good dupes for more expensive palettes. So if you guys want to see those videos, I'll try and remember to link them as well. But these are so fun and pigmented. My favorite one is the Hot Jalapeno. That's really the fun colored one. And these ones are great neutrals. If you have neutral loving friends, these ones are fun too, but I haven't played with them as much. And then this one, I haven't tried the blue shade in this yet, but they're super cute, totally worth picking up. And I think they're just so cool for every day, and you can put them in your makeup bag and great for people like commuting to work and stuff. I don't know. I just love how tiny these are. Like they're the size of my finger. So if that gives you any idea of how small they are, I just love these guys so much. Okay, so if you guys know anything about teeny tiny palettes, you probably have already seen these a million times or own a couple of them yourselves. I didn't like the original launch of these, but I did really like the Precious Stone. So she did the Emerald, which is the green, and then she did Sapphire, which is the blue. There's also an orange one. I don't have that one. This is Ruby, which is reds, and then we have Amethyst, which is the purples. And then after that, she did these ones, I believe. And these are the Neon Obsessions. I didn't really like these, but I was so excited when I saw these in the promos that I picked up both shades, or all three shades. I ended up taking the green back because I really didn't like the green, and then it was too late for me to return these. So I still have them. Every once in a while, I try to make them work, but they're not that great, so that was a miss. And then she did the nudes, and we all loved the nudes. I had so much fun playing with this palette. I did a collab with my friend Angie and Amy. We each bought a different color, and that was such a fun collab. You guys really enjoyed that. I really liked this palette, so I am so happy I picked this up. Then she did the pastel ones. So she did, I can't remember what they're all called, but she's like a mint, a rose, and a purple, or like a lilac. I'll put a picture up on the screen now so you guys know what I'm talking about. But since I have the ColourPop versions of those shades, I decided to pass on those. And it doesn't look like they're very tan girl friendly, so I'm glad I didn't spend $30 on those. Okay guys, so here's a one-off mini I have from Menagerie Cosmetics. This is their Violet Ink palette. Such a beautiful palette. This shade, oh my god, it's so beautiful. You'll see it swatched in my purple mini palette battle if you guys are interested. But yeah, how cute. We stan Menagerie because they make all their palettes like animal themed. So I just have such a special place in my heart for this brand. Okay, so I have two little guys from Dose. I ended up picking this one up on sale. It had such good reviews. It was a holiday launch from like 2018, and I refused to pay a full price for it, so I waited until it went on sale, and I did snag it. It's such a good palette, and I'm so glad I have it. I wish I used it more. They have some other shades of this particular size palettes on their permanent line, but I wish they would do more. I wish they'd do some more colorful ones because they have a lot of neutrals, but they don't have any colorful ones. This palette is the palette that sold Dose of Colors to me. I had tried their original Dizzy and Kitty palette and I thought it was so bad. And then they did the I Love Sarai collab and I was so nervous because I hated the one they did with Dizzy and Kitty the first time around. And then I bought this and it's so good. This blue is so delicious and it's such a little pop of blue palette, but you can do so many neutral looks, so many sexy like nighttime looks. It really packs a punch. And if you guys have been on my channel for a long time, you know I stan palm print. I love palm print so, so much. My master bedroom is like palm print themed. So I love that palette. I'm so glad she chose this packaging. I'm a sucker for palm print. What can I say? Okay, guys. So these are probably some of the most famous little minis in town. These are the Natasha Denona mini palettes. She's got a ton more. I don't have all of them, not even close, but I did pick up the gold one. This is probably my favorite mini ever. It's so good. And then I bought this one just because these were all my favorite shades in the Tropic palette, but I didn't want to buy the Tropic palette because I heard it was awful. The Nude palette I bought because I actually got to meet her, which you guys have heard that story 100 times, but I met her in New York. She had a meet and greet the same time I was there. And then this is her newest little mini palette. And I recently did a review on this guy, so I will link that for you. And then I did a battle with this and the Elf palette in Cream and Sugar, so I'll link that for you guys as well. But these are so cute. They're such a great size and they're such a great way to try the Natasha Denona formula. So I love that I have like a few of these because they're so fun. Okay, last and certainly not least are my favorite minis. These are from the brand Kaleidos. You guys have heard me go on and on and on about these. They're some of my favorites. I want to rank these, but I literally just want to say they're all my favorites. So here is the Astro Pink. This is beautiful. They originally launched these three that I'm going to show you first, and then they launched these two last summer, I believe. And then this is the Futurism 2. I actually bought the first set myself, and then they sent me their summer collection. But you guys know we're currently in quarantine as I'm filming this with the whole corona thing. And honestly, I kind of want to make a video about brands I miss during the coronavirus. And Kaleidos is really the only one. I really miss this brand because I think they had a launch planned for early this year. I'm not really sure, but I am so sad that we didn't get to have that. I'm hoping that once everything calms down, they'll still launch something because I just want everything. I just want them to keep coming out with such beautiful palettes. These color stories are so fun and I love that they're small and compact and so just fun. I don't know why you wouldn't like palettes like this. I mean, they just make me happy. Like, these two shades just literally make me happy. So that is the last of it. Okay, guys, that is everything for my mini eyeshadow palette collection video. Thank you so, so much for watching. Let me know what your favorite palette was in this video. And if you guys like more palette collection videos, I will go ahead and leave my playlist at the end for you guys to check out. Thank you guys so, so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video soon. Bye.